King Jesus. Holy, holy, is your beautiful name, God Almighty. Jesus, my Jesus. Thank you, my Jesus. And in the journey, while sitting with the Lord and asking the Lord what I must change about, but not my words, Jesus, not my words, but the Lord's words, then the Lord just said to me, do not let pride into your prayers. It's so, so easy, family, to be a child of God, to be a prayer warrior, to be in the first, to be there. But it's so easy for pride to enter our prayers easily. So our first that you come to the Lord in repentance and say, Lord, you know, I'm a mess. Although it's not like I am. So for the Lord to come and just purify that. So today, family, I'm sharing of the jewels that we receive from our apostle, our pastor, our teacher, and our sister from the house. But in this as well, I'm also sharing the testimony of my journey in this year and the journey the Lord took me when I wrote, when I went back and when I reflected. And the journey that the Lord took me on, I was that person for years, family, for years, being in the church, wavering from this side to that side, between heart and world, until recently when the Lord stripped me there. I said to the Lord, Lord, strip me, circumcise me, do whatever you want, because I don't want to be that person, why are you hanging anymore? It's from the love of God, it's from the line, it's from the line, Jesus. I don't want to be on that side. I've gone there with the nonsense, but I draw the line. I called you out, my child, but you're stupid. You had everything that you had. I called you by your name. That's not anybody. So I said, no, Lord. I know I'm not perfect, Lord. I know I'm still learning, Lord. I know I have mistakes, Lord. I truly understood in that moment the true repentance in this heart. And that true repentance. The revelation I had in Jesus was see Jesus on the cross, repenting on my behalf, on our behalf, to add in my so that I may have a full life, a life fulfilled in Christ. Let that sink in for a moment, family. Jesus on the cross, you saw my face. Each and every one of us sitting here today are families. And in that moment, the Lord repented. Jesus repented for mistakes that I would make. Stuff I would say, stuff I would do, the Lord. Jesus said to Adonai, Lord, have mercy. And I repent. Jesus was without blemish, without blame. He was perfect. The perfect lamb, the perfect sacrifice. And in that moment, he said this now, I'm here to Apostle Michelle, Apostle Lizel, London, Ms. Norms, I repent on your behalf. The question is, what is visible changes of Lady Mama that reflects what I've learned and received? Have I applied faith with the Lord? I have to participate in my journey with the Lord. I have to participate in the destiny that you and I have. You go where Jesus is to drink from the river of my family. Jesus is everywhere but in my heart. That's the question today. Jesus is the river of life. We get everything that we need from the river. But where am I? Where am I today? And at the feet of Jesus, or am I off or am I drifting away from the Lord? Will the Lord find me in a posture of worship, in a posture of prayer, fasting, spending time in the Word? What my life, our life, to stay home this family if we keep on drinking from a dry place? A dry, dry place, we'll stay home this. Because how can I drink from a place where there's no substance, where there's no life? How do I measure the dry place? If I have unforgiveness in my heart, you say, yes, Lord, I'm here, but you are unable to see past the past. The past hurts. You will strive more. You will strive more than to flourish. Romans 12:2 teaches us to transform by the renewing of your mind, maybe, how we live it. Secondly, because for me, to a point where I have to say, even to say, Lord Jesus, oh my gosh, no. I don't want to feel this anger. I don't want to feel the shame. I don't want to feel this unworthy. That is removing of the mind, saying, yes, Lord, I know the truth that you speak about me. I am a child of God. I'm in his kingdom. I am a warrior in the kingdom of God. I am a prayer warrior. I'm a child of God. I am, the Lord is highly exalted in my life. Do I repent for weakness, laying ourselves bare before the Lord? So it doesn't help. I can say, Jesus, here I am, but keep that for myself, for myself. So I declare myself being before the Lord. Although the Lord knows in any place, but it's about the responsibility I take it about my obedience, bringing myself to the offering. To truly sacrifice our own agenda and cry out to the Lord, praying out to the Lord. What can I do in this day for the kingdom of God? Not what can I do today for Lizel to be one of us. We all really are pastors. We are forgiven. We all God's righteousness. We all God's beloved. We are all of that for you. So we have to come to that point and say, Lord, what is your kingdom mandate for this day? What is it that I must do for the kingdom today? Because I know the Lord has already supplied my needs. The Lord has already given all that I need. Yes, we must prophesy good things into our lives. We must prophesy and follow me. We must prophesy life into our lives. Yes. But what can I do for the kingdom of God? Instead of ranting and listening for God, but to worship God in spirit and in truth. The spirit and the truth will set you free. My apostle is saying, I must ask if you are listening. Amen. Amen. Our family away. This is God speaking. None of this is me. It's all God. It's all Jesus. Authenticity is living a life that God has set for you to live. Therefore, one may be measured by your fruit in the kingdom. God has given us to be, yes, God has given us authority to be atmosphere changers. I'm looking at myself here, but I will not be able to be an atmosphere changer in my house, my family house, in my family home, in my workplace, in the world out there that the Lord has commissioned us to do. If I stay unforgiveness, a negative attitude, but from my heart. Being accountable will reflect the authenticity in my heart. I was like, just for a moment, just reading that again, thinking about it again, Jesus. Now the Lord spoke to me and I was like, I have to touch Jesus. And being accountable reflects authenticity in my heart. So then I said, okay, Lord, but I am being accountable. So how authentic am I really? How honest am I really? Put you first, God. Because before I can go to my apostle, my pastor, because I have accountability with my father, with my teacher. Before I can go to them, I first have to go before the Lord and say, Lord Jesus, I messed up. I'm sorry. I'm really, really sorry, Lord. But the testimony then is that I became more aware of the sinful nature in my own life. Yes, I have sinned, people. I confess before the Lord. I have sinned. And that sin, that needs urgent attention and healing. Urgent attention and healing, like great house today. And the sin can be from being giving someone like a loop or a high or what. It can be anything, guys. Anything that is opposite from the heart of God, anything that is opposite from the nature of God is sin. It's not of God. It's not of the Lord. So yes, we are human. Yes, we are human nature, we are flesh people. Yes, we are. We are not Jesus. So every day we live to live a better life in the Lord. So in being authentic, revealed and reflected my true character, who I really am. And the testimony I just shared my apostle, my pastor, wrongdoings, I had to be accountable to them first to bring each of the Lord in. True repentance in the sense of being transformed and not to some choices, but you just but you just are saying sorry, but you change your ways and not in ways anymore. So if I in the past normally follow my car in a straight way, and my teacher comes and says, "Daddy, please walk your car just a little bit there to make space for someone else." Not to get upset about it, it is my teacher. Lord, help me so that I can be thankful, direction, Lord. Let me try to do it better so I can make space for someone else to be able to bond with. That is our simple example, but to change my ways and doing this. Not to do it the same way. Because then I didn't change my ways, and I didn't allow the Lord to come inside me and transform me and change me. God is good, family. God is his love.
Consciousness. God is calling out of our kingdom consciousness today. So what does that mean?
churches, right? So they said, I go and I thought my thoughts off. My conscience will bother me. I'll probably the moment and say, so, okay, you know, sorry, sister. But my mother thought my conscience will bother me because she's my sister and I love her. That action that I did in a moment because of my anger, root of unforgiveness, root of past hurts, root of we got our family tree, which are also important to us, right? So then that will happen. That you feel maybe bad and don't because but remember there's no condemnation in Christ. Romans, God doesn't condemn, but makes us aware. The question is, have you found your Elijah? If not, it is not too late for me. Ask the Lord to send your Elijah and intentionally invest from your side. As well. And if we don't know how to invest, ask the Lord. And if you found your Elijah, then sit with your Elijah and say, my Elijah, I know that you're my Elijah, and I'm your Elijah, but I don't know how to invest. I don't know what to say, I don't know what to do. And your Elijah will be there with you. Elijah will be leading you. And pray the Lord, we've got Holy Spirit inside of us, family. The all-knowing, giving us wisdom, understanding, all of that. So we have it inside of us. We've got the Word of God. We've got so many of the toolbox that the Apostle taught us about. The Lord says it's not just a shiny thing that you can just keep around and maybe open it when you feel like it. God has given us the toolbox that's inside of us. Because the blood of Jesus is running through us. We have the heaven mandate, but all of that the Lord has got inside of us. Just ask. The Lord, I want you. I want to be a vessel. I want you to be better. I want you to mourn, but I don't know how. Trust me, the Lord will show you. Knowing is not enough, family. Knowing is not enough. It's not enough. It's not enough. I always just knew and knew and knew. And instead, I said to my teacher, I can't do nothing because I can't remember nothing. Birds just come to snatch it away. But have I read further, then the birds just come to snatch it away. People of a new generation that moves beyond knowing and putting their knowledge and tools that they have received over into action. So it doesn't mean I have a book and I have a pen and I have all I have inside of me but I don't write it down. Then we see the second. Act of Holy Spirit, that's a life. Pull down all the authority from heaven to earth to let it grow in the fruit of the Spirit. So if I've got a tree now, I've got roots that's planted in the good ground, which we see every day, when Jesus comes and he waters it. So I also have a responsibility because I like to write a lot of people. I've got seven guys at home. And I have to go before the Lord and repent because you know how much dust some of my family said. Prophecies that I went back and I actually shared with my apostle the other day, a prophecy that's sitting outside has been fulfilled that my apostle prophesied over me. Guys, that is Jesus, I'm over. That's all Jesus, my friend. Prophecy that came that's an abomination against the Lord. That is not okay. Things that I've written down. And then I went back and said, he's not bad, I wrote this down, so Lord, can you pray this into my day? Prophesy this over by the land today. I know that you're giving me all of this, Lord. This is from you, so I'm going to use it. No, it's not enough. And trust me, Lord, trust in the Lord that when you take that responsibility and you give the first step and you say, yes, Lord, the Lord will do the next. Then it will pass. Holy Spirit is going to activate us, to empower us. So that we are fully equipped to move forward and to be the hands and feet of King Jesus. That's it. Do not grieve or manipulate the Spirit of God inside of you. I would manipulate the Spirit of God inside of you. Is it not? But that one, what? So I was, what? So now I sit. And I sat, trust me. Offense, yes, thank you, my apostle. Offense. I sat here, there, where Sissy is sitting. I sat
Yes.
So if you're in a moment where you need to need repenting and you need to commune, the Lord will guide you and show you what to do, to say sorry, and to move forward from that. To move into a life of power and authority and action. I have to run to the throne room to have a burning desire for my relationship to grow within Jesus. Spending time with the Word, praying, applying to my everyday life, worship, fasting. Let us prepare the same time for you. It's very easy. It's very easy, my family. Pray to us at the same time. I feel it. And I try to justify things that I've gone through or whatever. And the Lord, has worked up that family. And if you don't know when it is gossip, trust me, the Lord will show you. But you can't serve a holy God because God is holy, God is holy. So I can't be mindful in that prayer that I am, that incense I bring to the throne room of God. At the feet of Jesus, I'm closing my eyes, and at the feet of Jesus, Jesus, I'm here, but Jesus, I am my mother. Jesus, but you know how I feel because I am my mother. No, Jesus says, you love your mother, forgive, as the Lord has forgiven us, forgive me. Accountability, fellowship, generosity, easy to get, four cultures of heaven. Family, we are all in a working, growing process. One day when we go home, we'll be shopping. But in this time that we are here, even if it's just nyanyi, because I struggle with fellowship, I say, oh, things will go by, I mean, then I have to do the dishes, I have to do this, I have to do this, I have to do this. So I confess, I struggle with that, and I try. At least if you try. Generosity, accountability, honor, I have not perfected it, and I probably will not. But intentionally, pray daily for my life to be alignment with those four cultures of heaven of God. Not, yes, apostle, yes, man, but it's God's cultures. That my apostle is possible for us, because God has placed everything in our apostle's heart and vision. And thank God that we have such a mouthpiece for us here, and that she brings down heaven to earth for us. Because imagine if we didn't have our apostle teacher, we didn't have his hands and feet, because unfortunately Jesus, not Jesus is here, but not in physical form. So he gave us a physical form. Let's honor! Honor the physical form! I mean, I believe many of you asked the question today, why did Sally highlight so much about forgiveness, repentance, to invest in godly relationships? Well, these four kingdom cultures became a part of my life, and I asked the Lord to strip me there once again. And I tried hard to remove the mask, the counterfeit, the filth. I was moved to the feet of the Lord. Because I was lying to myself, I was lying to God, I was lying to my leaders. I mean, only when I surrendered all truthfully, things started to change and happen in my life. And it did. In every area, I thought, this has been a rough year. But I know that stinky oil has been washed off. I know I don't always come out shining oily every day, but then I say, yes, Lord, I want your oil, the oil of heaven, to wash off me. So, Lord, I've got some grease today. Okay, you went to sleep last night, you get up grumpy. Okay, I've got some grease. But, Lord, please come wash over with your life so that this grease can go and I can be oily and shine for your kingdom. Because how can I be greasy and go into the kingdom of God? Family, the journey is different for all of us. But the most important thing is believe the Lord for daily throne room encounters every single day. I love the Lord so much, my family. So much. And I said, thank you again that I'm so to sit here and share today my online journey. But I hope that somewhere in each one of you, that jewel, that maybe just a little bit unfaced, you will say, Lord, I'm sorry, but here I am. And just love the Lord.